At the Medical School of the University of Washington in Seattle, Richard Blandow, PhD, MD, has sent hormones directly into the ovary and watched eggs emerge from the follicle. But not even the highest magnification of the ovum or its follicle has given him the answer he wants most. How does a hormone make a particular follicle rupture and a particular egg escape?
You may have two follicles located within exactly the same area, sitting side by side, and they may have exactly the same appearance. One will ovulate, the other will not. So something happens within the wall of the follicle that finally leads to ovulation. And to me, this is the crux of the whole problem of ovulation. What is it within the wall of the follicle that eventually will cause that follicle to be ovulated?
This remarkable film, produced by Blandow, of the ovary of a living rat, shows second by second the events that surround the arrival of the hormone, the follicle's rupture, and the egg's escape.
We see that the follicle has grown to a certain size. The small cap, which is being lifted away, and this cap is called the stigma, and that is the site of rupture of the follicle. This then eventually ruptured, and the contents consisting of fluid then poured out onto the surface of the ovary, and eventually the egg with its surrounding cells. And when that happened, ovulation is completed.
What subtle mechanism is at work here? What does the hormone do? Does it somehow create pressure that stretches the follicle wall to the bursting point? Blandow decided to test this long-standing pressure theory. In a year-long series of well-known experiments, he managed to place the tip of a microscopic pressure gauge into a single follicle and waited to see what ups and downs of pressure might occur during the cycle of a female rat. The answer was that there is no significant change in pressure, even at the moment of ovulation itself. The key to the mechanism must lie elsewhere. Blandow's attention has been drawn to something that happens at the point on the follicle wall, where the rupture first begins.
We noticed that almost invariably at the point of the follicle that was opening, a peculiar change occurred within the tissues, and that this change involved primarily a loss of blood flow. So that on the surface of the follicle, a very circumscribed area, a very small area, blood failed to flow in that particular area. And wherever blood fails to flow, tissue dies.
The rupture of the follicle, then, had something to do with the sudden disappearance of blood vessels and a weakening of the tissue through which the egg bursts free. But why should a hormone cause a particular set of blood vessels to vanish? Why at one point on the wall and not another? To find out, Dr. Blandow must delve